with the sack. It's Friday, that means it's time for Postman Al.
Postman Al, Postman Al, Postman Al and Parla my pal.
What's in your sack, Al?
With Trev on Friday morning while Hugo is still snoring. Take a look what's in the sack today.
Postman Al, Postman Al, Postman Al, I'm Parlory's pal.
Hugo, here boy, here boy.
Jill wakes him in the morning, Frosty stop him snoring. Let's take a look what's in his sack today.
Postman Al, Postman Al, Postman Al, I'm Sinclair's pal.
I'm not a hero.
We love a Friday morning, Al champagne's always pouring. Let's take a look at what's in his sack today.
Do you know what? If you could look in the future, you know, 25 years ago, thinking, would I be doing this? For God's sake! Honestly,
I've gone from talking about human rights in the Geneva Convention to do Postman Al.
I know. Honestly, Nick are laughing their heads off at us.
At least you can sing, Al.
All week we've been sending in your questions and problems to us here at Talksport. It's down to my Friday team of Ray and Trev to help me with advice for the listeners. So let's open our first letter. And this one's for you, Raymond.
Here. My daughter's only gone and brought her new boyfriend round for the first time, and he sat straight in my armchair. He's taken over the telly remote, and he keeps helping himself to Peronis from the fridge. He's even making jokes about me barnet. Is he too comfortable? Should I confront him?
I've got that problem now.
No. You caught him on the the door, didn't you? The doorbell.
Oh yeah.
And it was the cobras he's nicking.
No, he's nicking me cobras. Yeah. Seriously. And I said to him, I'll get you some Budweisers, no problem, but don't take my cobras. I've got sort of that problem at the moment, but he's a good lad who my daughter's going out with, and he's around quite often. What can I say? I think you've got to try and do the best you can for your daughter, and if she's happy, then you've just got to get on with it.
Is he too confident, this fella?
No. We can bring him back down to earth whenever you want, but I'm very lucky.
What's
at the
his
moment.
Name, Vincent?
What? No, Ollie. I'm lucky because he's a really good lad. He's working hard, which is good, which I like to see as a 20-year-old. But the worst thing he can ever do is take my cobras out of my fridge. And he knows that now. And I think that he's got the...
But I'm told he's going to unlock and put stuff in your tab. Right, let's open the next layer. This one's for Trev.
I've lost my hair. My wife keeps calling me a bald egg. I don't really pull off bald look, to be honest. I've even got pigeons pecking at my head. Should I go and buy syrup? Or what can I do to pull off bald look?
Wow. Trev.
Why is it always about Barnet?
Trev, I have nothing to do with this. Trev, I have nothing.
That's definitely Kim.
What do you think?
Listen, any man in this situation, I think you've just got to own it. You know, I know there's a new generation of people who want to go out to Turkey or wherever they go and get a weave. But for me...
A weave?
You know...
We've got people here weaving all the time in this building. Aren't we, Mickey?
For me, you've got to own it. You've got to accept what it is. It's a bitter pill when you first get it, but accept it. Take it all off. Don't try and get the old Bobby Charlton and keep it going. Just accept your fate. Get it shaved off, a number two all over, or whatever you want to do, and just own it. And listen, it's all about the confidence. It's all about how you approach life.
I'm looking old Jarhead here to my right. I'd rather have mayhem than walk about like that.
He's getting a bit today, isn't he? Just accept it, wear it, own it, and you've got it all to do.
Just one more, and this one, here we go.
This is
for me.
The best one.
I've moved into a new house in London with my friends. The oven, fridge and washing machine all don't work and there's damp all up the walls. I've asked my estate agent to get it sorted and he's just told me to stop bothering him because I'm giving him a headache and making him stressed. What should I do?
Ooh, you got a few houses out. What would you do as a landlord?
I've got a few houses. That's ridiculous.
Landlord. It should be not postman now. Landlord Al. Landlord Al.
Well, you have to look at your agreement, your landlord's agreement, haven't you? You know, you have to look at it and say, hold on a minute. And unfortunately, you have to get a lawyer involved, don't you? Or you send in the heavy, simple as that. It depends what he's like.
Heavies?
You know, yeah. If he's a bit of a tube, you send the boys
in.
If not, then you have to go legal, don't you?
You're going to send Jared in there?
Yeah, couldn't face sleep, honestly.
What do you think of state agents, though? He's welcome.
Just lately, with what's been going on with prices, we've had gazumping in Suffolk.
And
let me tell you, my middle one's finally got a house, but she got let down so many times. Mm. So I'm afraid the old estate agent, you know, what they're like, you know, we thought maybe, just maybe.
Love a pound note.
They were being human again. Nah. They're at it again. So listen, you need to take a bit of advice and have a look at your agreement. Simple as that.
Talk Sport Breakfast with Alan Brazil. Thursday and Friday morning, 6 till 10, on AM, on DAB, via the TalkSport app and on your smart speaker. TalkSport.